Manny was an absolute sellout crowd this past Wednesday night at the Convention Center in Miami. Our championship wrestling camera crew, of course, on hand to film this most important match, the Florida Heavyweight Championship, a title that you've held now for just a little over a year. And at this point in time, Manny, you seem to have things pretty well under control.
You know, Gordon, ever since I've had this title, I've fought, I've stayed in shape, and I've defended it for my people here in Florida. I come out there and I'm ready to defend it with everything I've got. This man, Muraco, he's a top athlete, great shape. You can see he's a heck, good-sized man, and I know we're going to do battle. We're out here to do battle, but right now it looks like I got the upper hand on me. I'm a little fired up because it's a sellout crowd, and those are my people out there. They're rooting for me, they're cheering me on, they're coming in with me. But I knew I had a fight with this man, and I knew it was going to be a tough one. And right now, as you can see, I'm working to try to get him to submit on the arm.
Obviously, here at this point, Manny, as I said earlier, you seem to have things well under control. Muraco, of course, the challenger, was having to come after you, but it appeared to me that you were totally aggressive in this. You were not backing away. You were not stalling for time. You kept the action going toward him.
You know, in all the times I defended my title, I've always gone on offense. I go after my man. I never play defense. Now, I'm always out there. I'm out there to show them that I deserve that belt. And I'll fight with what it is. As you can see here, he's trying to get me. I come up with a drop kick there. Back to the arm. Work on the arm. Try to get him to submit that arm. Try to take the weakness out of the arm. That way, he's only got one arm to fight me with. And when he does that, well, that's to my advantage because I should be able to work on the man and make him give it, hopefully. But as you can see, Morocco's a tough man in his own. He's holding his own, too.
He's obviously not the kind of a man to give up easily. And, of course, if you can get that arm, you take away a point of balance, a point of attack, and a point of... All right, now, once again, here is where Muraco shows he has that tremendous staying power. Charges in, crashes that elbow into that steel ring post, and this, again, a good bit of good fortune for you.
Yeah, I was thinking. I saw him coming. I thought I could move. I better get out of the way. Now I'm back to his arm. I'm working it. I'm still working it. I know by now that arm is feeling the pressure. I know that arm is going numb. I'm trying to get it now to submit. The referee's asking, as you can see, and I'm trying harder and harder each time to make him submit with that arm. And I keep working. As you can see, I still go all after that arm. Make sure that he's only got that one arm to my advantage.
Muraco, of course, known as the most dangerous man in professional wrestling with that Asiatic spike. And, of course, right here, he stunned you with that elbow and has you rocked, now catches you in the throat with that spike.
I don't know what it is that he's got done to that thumb, but I'm telling you, that is a very dangerous thing that he does. He hit me in the throat yesterday, as you can see, and I thought for a while there my Adam's apple split in half. It's hard to breathe because it clogs up all your air coming out of there, and now he's working on my leg, and he's working on the biggest muscle in my leg, the side. It's so hard to move. See, as he took it, like I was taking advantage of his arm, now he's taking advantage of that leg. He's trying to get that leg, so I'll be on one leg, fighting him back on one leg. But I got a little fire on my own, and I don't give. I don't know what the word means, and I keep fighting back no matter what it takes. I got that Latin soul in me that just won't let me give.
And that Latin lightning has caught a magnificent Muraco. Muraco backing away again. The two of you close in, and again, Manny, you appear to be beginning to dominate the match.
Yes, you know, I had to go out of, I can wrestle, and I love to wrestle. And when a man takes me to extremes that I have to use more than wrestling, I will do it. I will fight fire with fire. And now I go to his leg. I'm using spin toe, as you can see.
And then that spike caught you again.
Caught me again. And it just takes all the wind out of you. It just shuts your throat off. You know, you can barely breathe as it is. He throws me in, he whips me in, he catches me again with that big spike. I'm literally stunned now. That thing is something. As you can see, he's opened me up pretty good.
A severe laceration, no question about that. Using that spike once again. And the magnificent Muraco now obviously feels that he has everything going his own way. And again, presses that advantage. But Manny, you're not to be turned back. You're not to be denied.
I'm not. I got the fire in me. As you can see, here it comes. The Latin's coming out. That Latin enlightenment's coming now. I'm firing up. I'm going to get him now. I feel him. He just overdid it. You can see the flying punch to the knee. The head, I'll do anything now. I feel like I got the upper hand. I'm ready to beat the man. I'm ready to keep my belt.
Beautiful vertical suplex, and all of a sudden, you crash into the referee. Frenchy Bernard stunned, knocked unconscious, coming off the ropes. Both of you colliding with each other. Both of you are down. You try to get back to your feet, man. You tried gamely, but the lights went out.
Everything went out. And the
And suddenly, out of nowhere, appears this giant of a man. No question about this. Comes crashing down across you, Manny. At this point in time, he suddenly leaves the ring as suddenly as he appeared. He is a massive individual. He must be nearly 7 feet tall. Certainly no question about that. Muraco is still out. You're still out. The referee barely coming to.
That man came down on me. Had to be well over 300 pounds. Caught me in the sternum. Shut off all my air so I couldn't breathe. I couldn't see nothing. And I just laid out.
And there, the fatal count of three. The referee, the ring announcer now making the announcement. The magnificent Muraco coming out of that dazed and stunned state. Seeing you prone on the canvas. Got that arm over. The referee not aware of what happened. And it was a judgment situation with the referee. But now our camera crew followed this man back. Went back. And now look at this. And this is most interesting.
You know what? There's some people, and everybody knows that here in Florida, there's a man called himself a bounty hunter. As we can see, that is money. And that big man, I think I know who he is, and I think most people know who he is. And this is really disgrace to sports or anything that a man has to do, get paid to go out.
Well, now wait just a moment. In fairness to everybody involved, yes, there's money seen here, but we don't want to be in libel or slander here that we don't know that money's being exchanged. However, it's fair to assume with Sir Oliver Humperdinck and the magnificent Muraco and this giant of a man who I'm beginning to concur with you. I think we know who it is, but I don't want to risk the chance of saying the name. Something is going on here. There's no question about it. A conspiracy, perhaps. And nonetheless, it has cost you the title, Manny, and a very, very, very disappointing situation.
You're telling me, boy, I defended that title. He won that title. I must admit, I was beat, and I'll admit that.
Our camera crew now being run off.